In this video, I will walk you through a very complex but also very useful example on how you can use the filter function with multiple criterias and also only return the column or the columns that you want. Let's have a look on our data. We have order date, stock date, order numbers, and our product, sales territory key, and the quantity. And in this example, we want to return the order number and the sales territory key, both those columns, if the product is equal to strawberry. Let's write it here. And if the order date is between those two dates. That means that we will get the order number and the sales territory key if it's strawberry between these two dates. Is it possible? Definitely. Let's insert a couple of columns, make them a bit smaller so you can see. I go to H2 and I will write here in the formula bar our functions and explain how it works. First of all, we use the filter function, which will filter a range or an array. So the first argument is what we want to return, our array. In this case, we want to return the order number and the sales territory key. So we select all columns and then we go to the second argument. And in this argument, we set our filtering criterias. For example, we want the product to be equal the strawberry, F4 to lock the references. And in the formula bar, let's press Alt Enter just to make it easier for you to understand. And I go back here again. And if you want to have multiple criterias, each criteria needs to be nested in parentheses. So we make them in parentheses. And if you want to have an AND statement, meaning that it needs to be true for all the different criterias, then you make this multiplication sign. If you want to make it an OR statement, that it needs to be true for either one of the statements, then you make a plus sign. In this case, we want it to be an multiplication sign. So this is our first criteria. Let's go down a row and in parentheses, we select our order date is less than or equal to our end date. F4 to lock the reference, close the parentheses and create another one with the order date greater than or equal to the starting date, F4 to lock the reference, and then another parenthesis to close the filter function. What this will do is to return the order number, the product, and the sales territory key when it's a strawberry. But as you can see, we now return all three columns and we only want to return the first and the third column. What we need to do is to nest another function called choose_col. And we do it before the filter function. So before the filter function, choose_cols, return the columns from an array, and our array will be this filter function. So in the end, we write 1 and 3 and close it. So now you see that we will return only the first and the third column. And this is exactly how we wanted it to be. Also, before we're finished, it's good practice to also sort the returned array. So what you do is that before the choose_cols and the filter function, you write sort. So this will sort this array. So this array will return something. We go to the end, go to our second argument, and the sort index is the column you want to sort by. In this case, it's either the order number or the sales territory key. Let's write 1 to sort it from the first column, the order number, and if we want to have it as ascending or descending. In this case, let's make it descending. And then we close the sort function, and you will see that now you have it in descending order from the order number. You get the order number and the sales territory key in between these two dates for this berry here. So this was a very complicated but very useful scenario, and I hope that you followed along. Otherwise, just make a comment in the comment section and I will try to answer you as quickly as possible. Thank you very much.